The Center for Human Rights and Civic Education says it is worried that the federal government is losing the war against corruption. The executive director, Ibrahim Zikirullahi, while speaking to newsmen in Abuja, says that the ongoing events playing in the National Assembly involving the Niger Delta Development Commission shows that there is no longer any political will to fight corruption, a proof that the administration has lost its way. Zikirullahi says the nation's treasury has been left to the hands of looters, and the anti-corruption war only exists in the name.
The COVID-19 is not the only pandemic Nigerians are faced with in recent times. The plague of corruption continues to devastate the lives of citizens. It is one of the major tragedies of our country that the current administration, which came into office on the pretext that it was ready to fight corruption, has sunk neck deep into the same corruption it claimed it was ready to fight. As such, the administration has lost its way, thereby leaving the national treasury at the mercy of the very mindless looters, which the Nigerian people hope will be set packing from all aspects of governance. As a matter of fact, in the struggle between anti-corruption forces and apologies of corruption, the latter has been winning. What used to be called an anti-corruption fight only now exists in name. The loss of political will and the serious collapse of the moral ground on which the current administration would have fought corruption to a decisive standstill will be seen from the government's act of condoning clearly corrupt characters within its own fold. If this were not so, the sleazy and scandalous revelations coming out of the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, would have made many big thieves cooling their heels in cells of anti-corruption agencies in readiness for judgment day at the courts. There's no mistaking the fact that corruption is winning, because the same government which has failed to investigate weighty allegations against some of its very senior officials has been quick to suspend the acting chair of the EFCC, Ibrahim Magu, on grounds of alleged corrupt enrichment.